Cindy and I are currently heading to go apartment hunting. She wants to get a new place. We always kind of like to go together because we just think it's fun to look at houses and stuff. Excited?
Yeah, I'm so excited.
Why do you want to move?
I want to move because I pay a lot for like what I get. Like I have a really nice big house, but my apartment, like for what I pay, I could be getting like a concierge or like a nicer pool and like a gym.
She wants to step it up.
I don't want to pay more. This guy's sick. Stop, you're recording me. That guy's seeing me take selfies. I feel good. It is what it is.
Okay, so we just saw this place that Cindy wanted to see. The verdict is that it's not as nice. It's almost more expensive. It's really old and it comes with all this furniture that she wouldn't really want. So, on to the next one. You need any chicken? Why not? Bath salts? Isn't this that shit that gets you really, really, really cracked out of your mind? I saw that at grocery stores. You see this car right here? I really want this car. This kid's really cool. Well, that was wildly unsuccessful. We just tried to find a desk for Cindy's house because I'm not allowed to play music loud at my place because I did it too many times and I kind of abused it. So my neighbors don't love me anymore, so I need to move my studio to her house and I need it so that I can be working on music. So yeah, we need to find a desk that'll match her apartment and make it look all pretty for her. So the hunt for that continues as well as the apartments. We got a lot of hunting. We're going to my favorite store in the entire world because it's the coolest place and has so many things. Oh wait, there's a weird entrance now, but we're at Guitar Center. Look at all this stuff. So you're just looking at like keyboards, right? And then you see this crazy hole that goes who knows where. That's really weird. Well, I'm sad because I wanted to get these like key things that you put on a keyboard because I'm trying to learn how to play chords better and be able to like compose by myself. Well, to be honest, I thought that I was gonna have like dinner and hang out with Cindy tonight, but she's gonna hang out with her homies and I kind of didn't really know, so I don't have any plans now. But anyways, have you guys tried this stuff ever? Rose water? Spray it on your face? It feels really nice. It's like really refreshing, especially like right when you wake up in the morning or like if you're trying to kind of meditate, relax, chill. I went to the grocery store and I got some chicken and some stuff, so I'm gonna whip up some food. Okay, time to cook. Chef Neels today is preparing rice pilaf with chicken of Jamaica. Okay, let's go. Rice pilaf. Organic Jamaican tenderized chicken. Pan. Okay, so I have an electric stove, which is really fucking annoying because it's just hard to understand. You just guess, and then if you don't get it right, you just turn it up, turn it down, you don't really know until it's cooking. So, there's that. What do I need? I need a knife. I need scissors. Where are my scissors? I'm gonna put on some music. I don't really know why, but I like listening to like Spanish or French music when I cook because it just makes me feel, I don't know. I don't know why. It just feels good. You guys like Maluma? I like Maluma. I'm gonna play Maluma. You see that? Okay, well, I'm missing supplies, which is annoying because I don't know how I'm gonna cook now. Never mind, I found it. It was in the dishwasher. I didn't know that because I don't know how to do dishes. So the secret to cooking rice, for those of you who don't know, buy microwavable rice. That way you don't actually have to cook it. Just like that, the rice is done. Only 90 seconds, baby. Look at that. Look at that. Woo-hoo-hoo. Yeah, this is really good. Like, really, really, really good. So, this video isn't all positive news. Unfortunately, someone stole $10,000 worth of clothes from me during Fashion Week. Now I'm gonna tell you the story. Basically, I was staying with my friend Nick in New York, and I was waiting for my friend David to be back in town so I could stay at his place. When David got back into town, I packed up my stuff. After spending a few days with Nick, I had a great time. We went to a music festival, by the way, which was insane. Look at this. So I was at Nick's, I was packing up, I got all my stuff together, and I had a bunch of laundry that I had, you know, worn for the first like 4 or 5 days that I was in New York. And then I just threw some other stuff in that bag that was kind of hanging out from my suitcase because I was just like kind of unorganized when I wanted to leave Nick's. So then anyways, we like hung out at his place, we had dinner, I was done packing, we called an Uber, and I was like, yo, can you help me bring my bags down? Because I had like 2 big bags and like my laundry bag. I go outside the doorway, I know 110% sure I had the laundry bag, I had the other bag, and then Nick had the smaller bag. I get into this Uber and all of those 3 things were in there. I was very, very, very clear because I helped pack the back of the car. I shut it, like I looked at it. It was there, 110%. Fast forward, right? We drive down from 42nd Street in New York all the way down to Soho. Once I get to Soho, I pull up to David's place and you gotta walk like all the way up 2 flights of stairs, which is the one only annoying thing about his apartment, which is really, really cool. It's just, you gotta walk upstairs and I'm really lazy. Especially when you have a lot of big bags that are heavy, it's kind of annoying. I go up the staircase, I had like my stuff, right? Well, I thought so. I get upstairs, I'm hanging out, like an hour goes by. I ordered like some matcha, I had like a soft serve, I was hanging out. I had like 2 other friends over, we were totally chilling, low key. I realized, I was like, wait, where's my laundry bag? So I went and looked around the house and I couldn't find it and I was like, holy shit, I left it in the back of the Uber. This was only like an hour later, you know what I mean? Like the driver definitely wasn't out of service, like it wasn't that late at night, he was still most likely driving around. So I tried calling him because you can call through Uber and like figure out, you know, how to get your stuff back, and usually they charge you like $25 and they bring it back and like, end of story, case closed, done. I call this guy, no answer. I call him again, no answer. I call him 2 more times, no answer. I finally called him from my friend's number then, because I was like, maybe he's just ignoring my phone number because he knows I left something there or something. So then I started getting sketched out because I call him on Nick's phone. He answers. I was like, hey man, what's up? I just want to let you know, I think I left something in the back of your car. I need you to come and drop it off. I'm happy to pay the return fee and, you know, any gas and plus a tip, whatever, like no problem. Little did he know, there was $10,000, maybe even more, but literally $10,000 worth of clothes in there. I know that sounds stupid and I probably shouldn't have had $10,000 of clothes in a laundry bag that looks like it was kind of trash. I did. I get on the phone with him, right? I'm like, yo, I need to grab my stuff. He's like, I mean, I didn't see anything in the back of there. I'm in the middle of a trip right now. Like, can I call you later? Blah, blah, blah. And I was like, all right, whatever, dude. Sure, but go look for it and call me later. I didn't get a call from him, so I call him back like 2 hours later. And I was like, he was like, hey man, I just dropped my car off at the shop for the night. It was having an issue. And I was like, okay, well, did you check for my bag? Because it was in the back of the car 100%. I know 100% because the only place that it could have been between leaving Nick's place and when I literally said that I packed in the back of the car and by the time I got to David's was in the car. The only place it could have been is in the car. So I'm like, you checked though for my bag in the back of the car before you went to the shop, right? And he's like, oh no, it's gonna be there overnight, or I might even get it in 2 days. I don't know, I'm gonna call you though. I was like, oh my God. Hopefully he calls me, hopefully I get my shit back. Whatever, left it from there. Then, 2 days go by. 2 full days, no phone call, no email, nothing. I call him again, no answer. I call him again, no answer. I call him again, he blocked me. Then I was like, all right, this is getting sus. So I took Cindy's phone because she was in town at this point, and I called the guy off Cindy's phone. He finally answers and he's like, hey, stop calling me, motherfucker. Like, I don't have your shit, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, I didn't even ask you yet, but like, why wouldn't you have it? Because you took your car to the shop, it was 100% in your car, you picked it up and you're saying now it's just not there. So either A, you stole it, or B, the people at the car shop stole it. As soon as you open that bag and you look at the tags in there, I mean, I had Gucci, Saint Laurent, Amiri, Off-White, like just too many designers. Anyone with half a brain would have been like, wow, if I had stole this and sold it, I could make some money off it. And he gets on the phone, I'm like, you have my bag, bro. I know you have it, stop lying to me. He's like, I don't have your shit. If you think I have it, then you're just a dumbass. Like, you can go screw yourself. I'm just a driver, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, this is retarded. I finally was like, all right, I'm gonna contact Uber. I'm gonna contact the police or whatever the hell seems the best. But at the time I was like, Uber, because the police aren't gonna do shit. They're not gonna care about some stupid laundry bag from some kid who left a bunch of designer stuff in it. I messaged Uber, I tweeted them. I don't know if you guys saw, I deleted it because I felt bad. People started commenting on me, hating me and saying that I was some mean person, but really, I'm the one who got screwed here. I tweeted Uber, I emailed them, I tried to call them, a million things, and no one was like really understanding that this guy most likely stole my stuff. They were like, oh, well, you know, because we're Uber, we have our own contract with the driver and you have your own relationship with the driver and that's between you guys. And I was like, okay, well, I called him and he's denying he has it. He blocked my number on my other phone. This is obviously sketchy. You guys need to help me. Granted, another important fact, I spent $50,000 last year on Uber. $50,000 on Uber. I know that sounds like a shitload of money because it is. That's $4,000 a month roughly. So I'm like, guys, I spend thousands of dollars a month on your platform. I'm a trusted customer. I always get nice cars. I use it literally anywhere from minimum 2 up to 10 times a day, even more sometimes, depending on what's going on in my life. Their responses were so like robotic that I was like, yo, you guys need to get me to a human. I need to speak to a human right now. Finally, like someone emails me and they're like, okay, yeah, you just need to contact local authorities. And I was like, dude, you and I both know damn well, local authorities will look at this and not give a shit. You guys need to take it upon yourselves to help someone, especially because I spend so much money on your platform. Like, take care of me. Why are you gonna help me out? How, that's bad business, bro. After like a day of trying to get through Uber, they wouldn't get me back. They literally stopped replying to me at one point. The guy blocked me on my phone. He's denying he has it. Uber blocked me now. People are hating on me on Twitter for complaining that someone stole my shit and blaming it on me. Not a great day, right? So then I got really mad. There was a maid at David's house and I was telling her, and she's like a hardcore New Yorker, and she was like, oh, I would have totally gone over there and I'd have kicked his ass and blah, blah, blah. So I was like, you know what? You know what? You're right. I'm gonna get mad and I'm gonna call this guy and I'm gonna bitch him out. Called him from another number. What's up, dude? You can stop lying to me now because I know you have my shit, and if you don't tell it right, or if you don't cough it up right now, I'm gonna call the police. He was like, fine, call the police, you stupid asshole. Like, I don't have your stuff, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, fine, I'll call the police. Then he texts me after and he's like, oh, you think you can threaten me? I'll threaten you, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, you stole my shit. Like, it's fine. I'll pay whatever fee for you to come and bring it back. I'll even give you something inside of it. Literally $10,000 worth of other clothes in there. So I'm expecting you to be a kind person and bring that back. 2 days later, no response from anyone. Uber literally completely ignored me. He stopped responding to me. Absolutely no one heard of it. So then I'm thinking, all right, maybe I'm somehow so stupid that I like left it somewhere in the apartment and I really can't find it. I literally tore David's apartment up everywhere. Like, the entire place, I tore it up. I couldn't find it anywhere. So then I'm freaking out. I call my mom and I'm like, Mom, what do I do? She was like, oh, you need to call the police. Everyone's like, you need to call the police. And I'm like, not gonna work, whatever. Then after a few people told me to call the police, I was like, whatever, I'm gonna call them. So I call the police and I'm like, hey guys, blah, blah, blah. Here's what happened. It's this kind of car. It happened at this time at night from this location to this location. You know, here's the chain of events with the driver. He blocked me, all this different stuff. And they were like, oh, that sucks, man. But you know, to be honest, like, probably not anything gonna happen. The cop told me that. The cop literally said, nothing's gonna happen. So I was like, all right. Uber blocked me, this fool blocked me, the cops are now blocking me, and $10,000 of my clothes are gone. What the f-? I'm really upset now because a lot of what was in that bag were my favorite pieces, because usually when I get somewhere, especially when I'm going to like a music festival and I was hanging out with a bunch of my friends, I wanted to look good. I was wearing nice stuff. I was trying to feel good and, you know, just give off good vibrations. I literally had all my favorite stuff in there, including a shirt that I bought 2 weeks ago. I wore one time and it was $800, which is really stupid, but it was an $800 shirt. I wore it one time. Now this guy has it. He's either wearing it or he gave it to his kids or he sold it and made money off it. I don't know, but it was my shirt. Everything in there was mine and now it's gone and I have to suffer. So anyways, I have a new shirt on it with a car. I have some other clothes up there that are new, but the problem is also, I've been selling a bunch of my clothes recently because I'm trying to change up my style and get rid of them, but like, I wasn't really ready for that. I wasn't ready to lose like all my favorite stuff. I was kind of like gonna slowly get rid of the other things and like, you know, have it be a gradual process, but nah, gone. All of it gone right away. That was that. I'm really frustrated. Especially because the lack of support and the fact that people literally started blaming it on me, including people on Twitter, which was really annoying. I might sound like a spoiled brat and this might sound stupid, but moral of the story is that you should always be a good person, and if you make a mistake or if you see someone make a mistake, you should help them correct it. You should help them be, you know, a better person. And I was trying to give this guy an opportunity to be a good person. I was gonna give him money. I was even gonna give him clothes, and no. Nothing. I really don't even know what else to say. I'm flabbergasted. I'm shocked and annoyed that this is really what I'm living with now. But I guess it's time to go on a shopping spree and buy a bunch of stuff. So maybe that's the next video. Otherwise, New York was absolutely amazing. I walked a really fun show. I got to see so many of my friends. I launched a sunglasses brand. I had dinner with cool people. I hung out with my girlfriend and friends. We went to movies, events, parties, so many positive things. I met amazing brands. And one of the best things was that I signed with my new agency, and this was our first season showcasing, you know, what's going on with another, what is going on with one another. So that was a lot of fun to like kind of get the team all really excited and, you know, move everything in motion. So I had a really exciting and positive fashion week. With that being said, I did want to thank everyone one more time for giving me the love and support you've given me. You guys honestly are the reason that I am able to put myself in a position where I can go and work for all these brands, work with agencies, have high level conversations, pitch myself for opportunities, etc., etc.
Is that my mirror? I got this mirror the other week at the flea market. I thought it was really cool, but now I have an idea. I'm gonna put another mirror there and another mirror there, and I'm gonna have it be like a whole thing of mirrors. So that's my mirror wall.
Anyways, this was kind of a sad video, at least for me. I feel like I got really screwed here, but I have you guys still, and I will buy new clothes, so it's not the end of the world. Long story short, remember to live every day like it's your last. If something happens to you, as much as it might suck, especially if you lose money or you physically got hurt or someone broke your heart or whatever it is, just remember that the world is still going to go round, especially the next day. The sun's gonna come up, the birds are gonna chirp, the frogs are gonna ribbit or whatever they do. But that's that. I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. I will be coming back to you guys next week. Stay strong. I love you.